this tutorial we will create a surrealistic magical fantasy image with the standard options in GIMP, so there are no plugins required. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the images in the video description. I hope you have fun with this video. We will start by selecting all the images in our image folder and bring them into GIMP by drag and drop. Make sure that the desert image is visible. Click on the zoom icon in the top right to maximize it in the window. Click on the flip tool and then in the image to flip the image horizontally. Now click on the tab of the lighthouse image. Then we go to the toolbox and activate the crop tool. Drag a framework, like so, and click in it to confirm. Click the fuzzy select tool active. Check the option feather and make the value 5 pixels. Make the threshold 20. Click on select by and choose blue. Now click in the blue of the image. Press Ctrl I to invert the selection so the lighthouse is selected. Now we hit Ctrl C to copy the lighthouse. Here we can see that it's copied to the clipboard. Then we click on the thumbnail of the desert image. Click Ctrl V to paste the lighthouse. Click on the new layer icon to change the floating layer into an actual layer. Double click on the name and change it to Lighthouse. Hit Enter. Activate the Move tool and check the option Move the active layer. Move the lighthouse to the left and place it like so. Then we activate the Rotate tool. Click in the image. Move the slider to around 15. Then click Rotate. Right click on the layer and hit Layer to Image Size. Go to the toolbox and select the Eraser tool. Choose Brush Hardness 100 and make the size about 50. Zoom in to the bottom of the lighthouse by press and hold the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel. Erase a bit of the bottom of the lighthouse to make it horizontal. The bottom of the lighthouse should be a bit higher in the picture than the tree, so it looks like it's further away. Select the desert layer. Activate the Free Select tool. Check the option feather and make the value 5 pixels. Zoom in and out by pressing the Ctrl key again and rolling the mouse wheel. Select a part of the sand, like shown in the video. Click the last point over the first point to make the selection. Then we hit Ctrl C to copy the selection. Select the lighthouse layer, and then we hit Ctrl V to paste the selection. Now we click and drag the selection to the bottom of the lighthouse. Move the image by holding the spacebar down and moving the mouse without clicking. Then let go of the spacebar. Press Ctrl C to copy again, and press Ctrl V to paste again. Click and drag this selection again to where the sand and the bottom of the lighthouse touch each other. When this looks okay, we click on the anchor and the floating layer is added to the lighthouse layer. Press Ctrl Shift J to fit the image in the window. Click on the new layer button at the bottom of the layers panel. Rename it Shadow Lighthouse. And hit Enter or click OK. Move it by click and drag below the lighthouse layer. Then we go to the toolbox and click on the paintbrush. Choose brush 050. Make the opacity about 70. Zoom in to the bottom of the lighthouse and click one time where you want the shadow to begin. Press and hold the spacebar and move the image by moving the mouse without clicking so we see the edge of the image. Let go of the spacebar. Then move the cursor to where you want the shadow to end outside the image. Do not click yet, but press and hold the Shift key to get a straight line, and then also press and hold the Control key to make the line exact horizontal. And now click one time. And there we have our shadow. Press Ctrl-Shift-J to fit the image in the window. Now we click and drag the thumbnail of the boy image via the thumbnail of the desert image into the desert image. Click and drag it one place down in the layer stack. Then we double-click on the name and change it to boy. Hit Enter to confirm. Click the Move tool active and click and drag the boy to the bottom of the image more or less like so. Now go to Filters, Light and Shadow, and hit Drop Shadow. We make the Blur Radius 4 and the Opacity 70. Then we click OK. Double-click on the name and rename it Shadow Boy. Hit Enter. Click on the Flip tool. And then click on the shadow in the image so the shadow is flipped horizontally. Click the Move tool again, and move the shadow to the left of the boy. Now we activate the Perspective tool, and at Guides we choose Center Lines, and change the perspective in a way that looks natural. If this is to our liking, click Transform. Right-click on the Shadow Boy layer and click Layer to Image Size. Then we activate the Eraser tool, choose Brush Hardness 75 and the size should still be around 50. Erase the parts of the shadow that don't look natural. Then we click on the paintbrush and we add some shadow to the boy where he touches his hand. Now we choose brush hardness 0.25, make the size about 75 and the opacity about 50. Then select the boy layer and add some more shadow, like shown in the video. All done, press Ctrl-Shift-J to maximize the image again. In the next step, we bring the captain into our image. Click on the thumbnail of the captain image and drag it via the thumbnail of the desert image into the desert image. Double-click on the name and change it to Captain. Hit Enter. Move the layer by click and drag to the top of the layer stack. Now click the Scale tool. Change the guides to center lines. Check the option Keep Aspect. Click on the captain. Now click and drag in the center circle to move the captain to the left like so. Then scale him down and move him until it looks as if he is walking towards the lighthouse. When you feel it's OK, you click Scale. Now we go to Filters, and here we can just click Repeat Drop Shadow. Double-click on the name, and rename it Shadow Captain. Hit Enter. Click on the Perspective tool, and change the perspective like shown in the video. When you think it's OK, we click Transform. Press Ctrl-Shift-J again. Click on the thumbnail of the sailor image. Activate the Free Select tool. Uncheck the option Feather. Now we make a selection of the sailor. We can click point after point, but we can also hold the left mouse button down and draw a line. Backspace key we can undo one or more previous made points. Use the Control key and the mouse wheel to zoom in or out, and the spacebar to move the image. Usually it works best when we stay just a little bit inside the boundaries of our subject. For the sake of the tutorial, we will go fast forward now. When we are close to our first point, we click the last point over the first point to make our selection. Now we go to the tool options, and at the mode we click on the third button, which is Subtract from Current Selection. Then we select the area within the arm. Again, click the last point over the first point to make the selection. When this is done, we press Ctrl-C to copy the selection. Click on the thumbnail of the desert image and press Ctrl-V to paste our selection. Click on the New Layer button to change the floating layer into a normal layer. Double-click on the name and change it to Sailor. Hit Enter. Go to the toolbox and make the Scale tool active again. Scale and move the image like shown in the video. Satisfied? Click Scale. Right-click on the Sailor layer and click on Layer to Image Size. Click on the thumbnail of the first vulture's image and drag it via the thumbnail of the desert image into the desert image. Double-click on the name and rename it Vultures 1. Hit Enter. Press the M key to make the Move tool active and move the vultures to the left top corner. Then change the mode of the layer to Darken Only. Now click and drag the thumbnail of the second vultures image via the thumbnail of the desert image into the desert image. Again, double click on the name and now name it Vultures 2. Hit Enter. Move this image to the right above the tree. Make its layer mode also Darken Only. To finish off, we click on the Cage tool. Check the option Fill Original Position. Activate the lighthouse layer. Place 6 points around the lighthouse. Then click the 7th and last point over the first point. Now move the 2 top points one after the other, as shown in the video. Every move may take some time, depending on your system. Done, hit Enter on your keyboard to confirm. And with that, we have made our own surrealistic magical fantasy image. I hope you have enjoyed this GIMP workshop. If that's the case, please give it a thumbs up, leave a nice comment, and subscribe if you haven't done already to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.